Welcome to another Terraform demo. If you're new to Terraform, you can take a look at these introductory videos to get started with Terraform for Dell infrastructure. In this demo, let us see how you can deploy PowerFlex storage together with a workload using Terraform with the same ease on both on-prem as well as on cloud, in particular AWS environment. In both environments, you're going to provision storage, map it to a host, and create a data store or a logical volume. Let us start with the on-prem use case. To set up a Terraform configuration, we need PowerFlex provider for storage and VMware vSphere provider for the compute. The configuration for compute and storage is specified in separate files for better readability and easier maintenance. In the storage configuration, we declare the volume resource that we need using some predefined variables for attributes like the storage pool, protection domain, and also make sure it is mapped to the VMware host with the corresponding SDC. Note that we are also capturing some PowerFlex objects here to be used later in the compute step. For the compute part, to create resources like a data store in the VMware environment, we need to first make sure the PowerFlex storage tasks are completed. Given the execution order in Terraform is not procedural, we need to explicitly mention dependencies to ensure the right execution order. To do this, we insert a time delay to allow the storage task to be completed before we do a rescan in vSphere for the available volumes. And only after this rescan, we actually create the data store corresponding to the newly created volume. In the data store definition, note that we are using an expression for the disk name to uniquely identify the correct underlying PowerFlex volume that we defined in the storage configuration. Here is the PowerFlex instance, and this is the VMware vCenter environment. Now let us deploy this configuration. The Terraform plan step shows the two resources we'd like to create, the PowerFlex volume and the corresponding data store in vSphere. Let us go ahead and apply the changes. We can verify that the volume has been created, and after the time delay, the data store has also been provisioned in the vSphere environment. And we can check that the data store is actually built on the PowerFlex volume we just created. Now let us see a similar use case with PowerFlex in AWS. Here the sequence we follow is to first spin up an EC2 instance with SDC component, which is the client-side component to use PowerFlex storage, and only then create the volume that is mapped to that SDC. For the EC2 resource, I'm using a pre-configured image and then running a couple of commands to complete the SDC installation. In the same EC2 resource definition, I'm making a connection to the instance and making sure the Terraform waits until the SDC component is active. Now, for the volume resource on PowerFlex, we can see that we made the EC2 step a dependency so that we can make sure the host is ready for us to map the volume. Before we deploy this configuration, let's make a quick check to see that all the variables have been properly defined in the .tfvars file. Here is the PowerFlex instance we are using, and here is the AWS portal before applying the configuration. We run the Terraform plan, and as expected, Terraform is going to create the EC2 instance and provision storage for it. Let's run Terraform apply. As per the dependency, we can see that first the EC2 instance has been created and the SDC installation steps are run. And then the volume creation happens almost instantly. On the AWS portal, we can see that the EC2 instance has been created, and on the PowerFlex interface, we can check that the volume has been created with the correct SDC mapping. We can also check to see the corresponding block devices on the EC2 instance as well. Thank you for watching this demo.